Hello everyone, hope you all are well. So today we will discuss about the parallel operation and tap changing method of single phase transformer, which is a very important topic in transformer chapter and as well as in electrical engineering. So myself, Mr. Santanu Naskar, assistant professor of electrical department, GKCM JIS group, and my mail ID is santanu.uyt@gmail.com. And santanu.nosco_gkcm@jisgroup.org, and this is my Facebook page, Being Electrify with Santanu. You can get all my lectures in my Facebook page and in also in my YouTube channel. So let's start. So before starting this, I want to share with you something which was told by Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. The function of education is to teach one to think intensively and to think critical. Intelligence plus character, that is the goal of true education. So let's start. So before starting the main topic, I want to share the syllabus with you. So the name of the course is Electrical Machine 1, and course code is EES3EM1. EM1 means Electrical Machine 1. So about the general introduction of rotating machine and DC generator and DC motor part, I have already covered. In single phase transformer, I have covered principle of operation, EMF equation, types of transformer, concept of ideal transformer, different types of cooling, performance under no load, on load, equivalent circuit, per unit representation, voltage regulation, OCSC test, losses efficiency, all efficiency maximum. And today I will discuss about this topic, parallel operation of single phase transformer and tap changing method, tap changers, offload and onload type. So let's start. So why parallel operation of transformer is required? So this is a question, why this is required? So to maximize electrical power system efficiency, this is required. First of all, it is economical to install number of smaller rated transformer in parallel than installing a bigger rated electrical power transformer. This has mainly following advantages. So these four advantages I have shared with you. So first is to maximize electrical power system efficiency. Generally, electrical power transformer gives the maximum efficiency at full load. If we run numbers of transformer in parallel, we can switch on only those transformer which will give the total demand by running nearer to its full load rating for that time. When load increase, we can switch none by one other transformer connected in parallel to fulfill the total demand. In this way, we can run the system with maximum efficiency. Number two is to maximize electrical power system availability. So in this point, if a numbers of transformer run in parallel, we can shut down any one of them for maintenance purpose. Other parallel transformer and system will serve the load without total interruption of power. And number three is to maximize power system reliability. So if any one of the transformer run in parallel is tripped due to fault of other transformer, if the system will share the load, hence power supply may not be interrupted if the shared loads do not make other transformer overload. Okay. And now last, to maximize electrical power system flexibility. So there is always a chance of increasing or decreasing future demand of power system. If it is predicted that power demand will be increased in future, there must be a provision of connecting transformer in system in parallel to fulfill the extra demand, because it is not economical from business point of view to install a bigger rated single transformer by forecasting the increased future demand, as it is unnecessary investment of money. again, if future demand is decreased, transformer running in parallel can be removed from system to balance the capital investment and its return. Finally, the transformer is said to be in parallel operation when its primary winding is connected to a common voltage supply. Look at this picture. And the secondary winding is connected to a common load. The connection diagram here of parallel operation of transformer is shown. So the parallel operation of a transformer has some advantages, like it increases the efficiency of the system, make the system more flexible and reliable, but it increases the short circuit current of the transformer. After that, I will discuss about some reasons for parallel operation. It's like why we need parallel operation, but there are much more reason to why we need for parallel operation. Because it is impractical and uneconomical to have a single large transformer for heavy and large loads, hence it will be a wise decision to connect a number of transformer in parallel. In substation, the total load required may be supplied by an appropriate number of transformer of standard size. As a result, this reduces the spare capacity of the substation. It may be a reason. And also, if the transformer connected in parallel, so there will be a scope in future for expansion of substation to supply a load beyond the capacity of the transformer already installed. And also, if there will be any breakdown of a transformer in a system of transformer connected in parallel, there will be no interruption of power supply of essential service. And if any of the transformer from the system is taken out of the service, which I have already discussed, for its maintenance and inspection, the continuity of the supply will not get disturbed. Next, I will discuss about some necessary condition for parallel operation. So when two or more transformer runs in parallel, they must satisfy the following condition for satisfactory performance. So these are the following condition of parallel operation of transformer. Number one is same voltage ratio of transformer. So if two transformer of different voltage ratio are connected in parallel with same primary supply voltage, there will be a difference in secondary voltage. Now say the secondary of this transformer connected to same bus, okay, there will be a circulating current between secondaries and therefore between primaries also. As the internal impedance of a transformer is small, a small voltage difference may cause sufficiently high circulating current, causing unnecessary extra ohmic loss. And next is same percentage impedance. So in this point, the current shared by two transformer running in parallel should be proportional to their MVA rating. Again, current carried by this transformer inversely proportional to their internal impedance. From these two statements, it can be said that impedance of transformer running in parallel are inversely proportional to their MVA ratings. In other words, percentage impedance of per unit values of impedance should be identical for all transformers that run in parallel. And also the point may be same polarity. In this point, polarity of all transformers that run in parallel should be same. Otherwise, huge circulating current that flows in the transformer, but no load will be fed from this transformer. Polarity of the transformer means the instantaneous direction of induced EMF in secondary. So if the instantaneous direction of induced secondary EMF in two transformers are opposite to each other, when same input power is fed to both of the transformer, the transformer is said to be in opposite polarity. If the instantaneous direction of induced secondary EMF in two transformer are same, when the same input power is fed to the both of the transformer are said to be same polarity. Okay, and the last point is same phase sequence. In this point, the phase sequence or the order in which the phase reaches their maximum positive voltage must be identical for two parallel transformer. Otherwise, during the cycle, each pair of phases will be short-circuited. So, the above said condition must be strictly followed for operation of transformer, but totally identical percentage impedance of two different transformer is difficult to achieve practically. That is why the transformer run in parallel may not have exactly same percentage impedance, but the values would be as nearer as possible. So next I will discuss about the parallel operation of a single phase transformer. So parallel operation of a single phase transformer means that the two or more transformer having the same polarities, same turns ratio, same phase sequence and the same voltage ratio are connected in parallel with each other. This circuit diagram of two single phase transformer A and B connected in parallel. Look here, they are connected two parallel transformer, transformer A, transformer B, where A1 is the turns ratio of the transformer A, A2 is the turns ratio of the transformer B, ZA is the equivalent circuit impedance of the transformer A referred to secondary, ZB is the equivalent impedance of the transformer B referred to secondary, and ZL is the, look here, ZL is the load impedance across the secondary, IA is the current supplied to the load by the secondary of the transformer A, IB is the current supplied in the load by the secondary of the transformer B, and VL is the secondary load voltage, IL is the load current. Now applying Kirchhoff current law here, what happened then? KCL, okay, look here, IA plus IB equals to IL, which is number one equation. Look here, IA plus IB equals to IL according to KCL. By Kirchhoff applying KVL, we can formulate VL equals to V1 minus A1 minus IAZA, which is number 2, and VL equals to V1 by A2 minus IBZB, which is number 3. Okay, now putting the value of IB from the equation 1 in equation 3, we can get VL equals to, look here, look those equation, VL equals to V1 my by A2 minus IL minus IA into ZB, which is number 4. Now solving equation 2 and equation 4, we can write IA equals to ZB IL by ZA plus ZB plus V1 into A2 minus A1 by A1 A2 into Z1 plus ZB, which is number 5, and IB equals to ZA into IL by ZA plus ZB plus V1 into A2 minus A1 by A1 A2 into ZA plus ZB, which is equation 6. Okay, now the current IA and IB have two components. The first component represents the transformer's share of the load current, and the second component is a circulating current in the secondary winding of the single phase transformer. Now, undesirable effect of the circulating current are as follows. What happened then? They increase the copper loss. The circulating current overloads the one transformer and reduce the permissible load kVA. And now I will discuss about the equal voltage ratio. So in order to eliminate circulating currents, the voltage ratio must be identical. That's mean A1 equals to A2. Okay, so under this condition, IA equals to ZB IL by ZA plus ZB, which is number 7, and IB equals to ZA IL ZA plus ZB, which is number 8. Now, equating equation 7 and 8, we will get IA by IB equals to ZB by ZA, number 9. Now, from above equation 9, it is clear that the transformer current inversely proportional to the transformer impedance. Thus, for the efficient parallel operation of two single phase transformer, the potential difference at full load across the transformer internal impedance should be equal. This condition ensured that the load sharing between the two single phase transformer is according to the rating of each transformer. If the per unit equivalent impedance are not equal, then the transformer will not share the load in proportion to the kVA rating. As a result, the overall rating of the transformer bank will be reduced. And from equation 9, we can also write that IA ZA equals to IB ZB, which is number 10. So the current in the equation 7 and 8 is changed into volt amperes by multiplying the two equations by the common load voltage VL. Therefore, we know that the total load in volt ampere VA is SL equals to VLIL. The volt ampere of transformer A is SA equals to VLIA, and similarly the volt amperes of transformer B is SB equals to VLIB. Hence, the various equation will be written as SA equals to ZB by ZA plus ZB SL, and SB equals to ZA by ZA plus ZB into SL. We can write, which is equation 11 and 12, and equating 11 and 12, we will get SA by SB equals to ZB by ZA, which is number 13. Now, equation 13 tells that the volt ampere load on each single phase transformer is inversely proportional to its impedance. Hence, to share the load in proportion to their rating, the transformer should have the impedance which is inversely proportional to their rating. Okay, so this is all the parallel operation of a single phase transformer. Now, I will discuss the tap changing method of transformer. Now, the question arises, the change of voltage is affected by changing the number of turns of the transformer provided with taps. What is this and what is the tap changing method of transformer? So, as I said, the change of voltage is affected by changing the number of turns of the transformer provided with tap. Okay. So, for sufficiently close control of voltage, taps are usually provided on the high voltage winding of the transformer. Okay. So, there are two types of tap changing transformer. One is off load tap changing transformer and another is on load tap changing transformer. So, in off load tap changing transformer, in this method, the transformer is disconnected from the main supply when the tap setting is to be changed. The tap setting is usually done manually. The off-load tap changing transformer is shown in this figure. This is the picture and this is the animation of tap changing method. Now I will discuss about the on-load tap changing method. So in order that the supply may not be interrupted, on load tap changing transformer are used. Okay, such a transformer is known as tap changing under load transformer. While tapping, two essential conditions are to be fulfilled. The load circuit should not be broken to avoid arcing and prevent the damage of contacts. No parts of the windings should be short circuited while adjusting the tap. Now, the tap changing employing a center tap reactor are shown in this figure. Okay, here S is the diverter switch. Look here, S is the diverter switch एंड 1, 2, 3 आर सिलेक्टर स्विच, 1, 2, 3 आर सिलेक्टर स्विच. द ट्रांसफॉर्मर इज इन ऑपरेशन विथ स्विच 1 एंड इज क्लोज टू चेंज टू टैप 2, स्विच एस इज ओपेंड एंड 2 इज क्लोज्ड. नाउ स्विच 1 इज देन ओपेंड एंड एस क्लोज टू कंप्लीट द टैप चेंज. इट इज टू बी नोटेड दैट द डाइवर्टर स्विच ऑपरेट्स ऑन लोड एंड नो करेंट फ्लोज इन द सिलेक्टर स्विच ड्यूरिंग टैप चेंज. ड्यूरिंग द टैप चेंज ओनली हाफ ऑफ द रिएक्टेंस व्हिच लिमिट्स दैट. नाउ इट इज नोटेड दैट द डाइवर्टर स्विच ऑपरेट्स ऑन लोड एंड नो करेंट फ्लोज इन द सिलेक्टर स्विच ड्यूरिंग टैप चेंजिंग. So during the tap change, only half of the reactance which limit the current is connected in the circuit. Okay, very easy process. So this is the circuit diagram. This is an animation. So after this, I will discuss about some reference book of your course, which is Electrical Machinery by Dr. Piers Bhimra. According to me, this is the best book in electrical engineering. And the second book is Electrical Machine by Ashfaq Hussain and Harun Ashfaq. This is a very good book for BTech student and also for diploma student. Next is Principle of Electrical Machine by V.K. Mehta, Rohit Mehta. To understand electrical machine clearly, it is a very good book. And some site, Electrical for You, Circuit Globe, and NPTEL's video lecture by IIT. Okay, so these are your reference. So thank you. Hope you all enjoy my lecture. So if you have any query, then comment in my comment box. I will definitely reply to your comment. And if you like my video, then like, share, comment, and subscribe my channel. Thank you.